You know how, when creating a new data type, it comes with a savable data page that only works for updating existing records? I struggled with this when I first started learning Pega. To this day, I still don't understand why that's the default configuration. In this video, I want to share a simple configuration for the savable data page that allows updating existing records, but also allows saving new records. Okay, so let me show you first the configuration. We have this case type called account management, and we also have a data type that is called account. In our account management case type, we want to include a page for our account data type. And this is our case type. First, we select an account. We can leave the account blank if we don't wish to update an account. In the next step, is where we are going to provide the information to update or save a new record. Then we have the save shape for saving new records or updating existing records. And then we are going to show a list of all of the accounts, and we will see that a record was added or the existing record was updated. Okay, so let's start by creating our page property. So here in data model for our case type, I'm going to create a new property. I'm going to call it account page. And it's going to be of type single page. So the page definition for this is going to be this one because we want the account. And I want to refer to a data page. So what's the data page? It's going to be the out-of-the-box data page, the account savable. And what's going to be the PYGID that I'm going to provide? Well, it's going to be the same PYGID that this property is going to have. So the ID for the property is account page. So I'm going to write dot account page dot PYGID. So now, here, in our select account, I want to have a section, an embedded section, where I display all of the information. Luckily for me, I already have some sections here that we can use. I have a default section, where I show all of the information of the user. And I have an update account details section, which is for writing all of the information. So let's add this to this view. So in my case type, I'm going to open the select account view. And here I'm going to add an embedded section. So I'm going to use a clipboard page, which is going to be the one property that we just created. So the class belongs to data account. So the class for the section, but my clipboard page is called account page, which belongs to work account management. And the name of the section that I want to display is going to be the default section. I'm going to move this above. I need to make some changes here. When the user selects an account, I want to send the PYGID, or I want to assign the PYGID to my property, which is account page. So here, so in my autocomplete field, here I'm going to add a new action that will happen when the user selects an account from this list. So I want to get the PYGID from the account list, and I'm going to set it to my account page PYGID. I'm going to click submit. And here I'm going to make this section a read-only section. So let's see if this works. So I'm going to save this. And let's run our case type. Okay, so let's select an account, for example, this one. And we can see that we have the information. I'm going to add a visibility condition so that this doesn't show when we don't have an account selected. Also, when I click on leave account selection blank, this is not being erased. So that's something that I also want to change. So let's go back to our section. So let's start by hiding this. So I'm going to hide this when we don't have a PYGID on this account page property. So the condition for visibility is that we only want to show this when we do have a PYGID. So I'm going to write account page and PYGID. So let me click submit. And the other thing that I want to do is to eliminate the PYGID from the account page when we click the leave account section blank, selection blank. Okay, so in actions, I have an action set where the event is click, and I have an action which is set value. So right now, what it does is that the account selected, which is this autocomplete, is going to be blank. Another thing that I want to do is to have the account page PYGID equal to blank. I know that this will not work in this order. The order of the values are important, so I'm going to move this over here. And this one will right here. So I think this doesn't work because the account selected has a refresh action when this changes. So for some reason, it's not also updating the account page. Okay, so let me click submit. And let's see if this works. So let's refresh. Okay, so now we can see that we don't see the account information. So let's select an account. And here we have it. If I click leave account selection blank, then it disappears. So that's great. So now if I select an account and I click continue, I want to be able to update information. So let's open this view, which is update account details. And let's add an embedded section. So once again, it's going to be a Clipboard page. The class is going to be our account class. And the Clipboard page is going to be our account page. To select this section, I'm going to use the update account details section. So let me click submit. And let's save this. Okay, so here we have all of the information. So now if I change something here, for example, instead of Andy Bernard, I'm going to say NardDog. Let's click create. And this should be updated. So here we can see that this is not being updated right now. And this is because we still don't have the save account configured correctly. So let's open this process. So here in Save Account, I'm going to view properties, and I'm going to use an associated property. Okay, let me create this on the latest rule set. Okay, Let's open the properties, and I'm going to use an associated property. The property is going to be the one that we created, our account page. Let's click submit, and let's connect this. Remember that our Savable page is the default one, the out-of-the-box page. So let's test if this works. I'm going to test it right now with creating a new account just to show that this doesn't work. So for example, I'm going to give some dummy data. So if I click create, we can see that we have an error. If I open the clipboard and see my account Savable page, we can see that the error is unable to load data page, the account Savable. Required parameters are PYGID. So this parameter cannot be blank. Okay. But if I go back and select an account, for example, once again, I don't know, this account. Let's continue. I'm going to update the username. If I click create, here we can see that Jim Halpert's account was updated. The username is now TunaFish. So this works when updating existing accounts, but not when creating new accounts. So let's fix that. So I'm going to open the account Savable data page. And what we want to do here is to add a new data source. So the default one is for updating accounts, but I'm going to add a new one. I want the first data source to be for updating accounts and the second one for creating new accounts. So I'm going to move this up here. So here I'm going to use lookup, and the class name is going to be account from the Office Data Account class. And the parameters, this needs the PYGID, same as this one below. So here I'm going to use param PYGID. And here I'm going to use a data transform. So the data transform is going to be called new account. So we need a condition. So the way that this is going to work is that if we provide a PYGID, then we want to update. But if we don't provide a PYGID, we want to create a new account. So I'm going to add a when rule. I'm going to call it PYGID provided. So let's create this when rule. Okay, let me move this over here. Okay, I'm going to do this condition in advance. I'm going to select the function for expression evaluates to true. And let me write a simple function. For this, I'm going to only use, I'm going to provide the PYGID as a parameter. So let me go to parameters. So this when condition is going to receive the PYGID. So I'm going to use param.pygid is different than empty. So if we provide here some information, some pygid, that means that we have a pygid. Yeah, click submit and save. So let's go back to our account Savable data page. Let's use that when condition, let's pass the PYGID parameter. And now let's create our data transform. Here, we need two data pages. We need our Savable data page, and we also need our PY work page where we are working our case type. So I need this PY work page that is created by account management, and I also need our T-account Savable. So let's go to pages and classes. I'm going to start with our account Savable data page. So let's write T-account Savable. Our class is going to be this one. And the other one is going to be our PY work page. And the class is going to be this one. Now let's go to definition. And the action we need is update page. So we want to update our Savable page with values from our PY work page, but from our page that we created, the account page. So here, for example, the username is going to be equal to account page username. And the same for all of the other values. So now that we have all of the values, I'm going to save this. Go back to my account Savable page. And let's update this to use that data transform. Something important is that because we don't need to provide the PYGID anymore every time that we call this data source, because when we go here, we don't have a PYGID, we need to make the parameter an optional one. So in require, I'm going to choose no. And now we can save this. So let's see if this works. Okay, I'm going to create a new account. Let's click create. And here we can see that we are creating a new record. Now let's update this record just to make sure that updating still is working. So let me find my account. Let's click continue. Let's update the email, the username. Let's click create. And yeah, we have the new email and the new username. So yeah, it is working. With this simple configuration, we are now able to update existing records and to save new records into the database. Just as an overview, this was the out of the box, the one that comes by default. And now we check if the user is providing a PYGID. If it is, that means that we are updating data. But if the user is not providing the PYGID, that means that we are going to save a new record. So here in our data transform, we grab the information from our PY work page and pass it directly to our data page, which is the Savable data page. So that's pretty much how it works. I hope you learned something new. I know I was struggling a lot at the beginning when I was learning Pega, but this is a very simple and elegant solution for this problem. Thank you.